Welcome. In this screencast, I'm going to talk about Spring Security integration with WSO2 Identity Server. I'm Randhika Navagamuwa, Senior Solutions Engineer for the Solutions Architecture team. WSO2 Identity Server 5.8.0 supports the following Spring Security integrations: SAML2 Single Sign-On, SAML2 Single Logout. In addition to this, we have developed an SDK that provides SACML-based authorization. Spring Security supports SAML2 Single Sign-On protocol to log into a Spring application through a SAML2 identity provider with single sign-on across Spring and non-Spring applications. WSO2 identity provider can act as a SAML2 identity provider in this scenario. You can refer the provided sequence diagram for a clear understanding. Spring Security supports SAML2 Single Logout protocol to log out from a Spring application that has already been logged in through a SAML2 identity provider, while at the same time logging out from all other applications the user is logged in through the same SAML2 identity provider. SAML2 Single Logout provides two types of bindings to send logout requests to the session participants. However, Spring Security supports only front channel synchronous binding currently. You can refer the provided sequence diagram for a clear understanding. Let's look at the prerequisites for the demo. To configure SAML2 Single Sign-On and Single Logout, refer the given documentation link. To run this demo, you need to configure Issuer ID, Assertion Consumer URL, Single Logout Response URL and Single Logout Request URL at minimum. To authorize a resource using SACML, first, we need to publish the relevant SACML policy to WSO2 IIS PDP. For this demo, you can find the policy I'm using in my GitHub repository. Refer the provided link for more information on SACML policy publishing. Finally, the SACML 3 REST API in WSO2 Identity Server can be secured in many ways, including basic authentication, OAuth2, mutual TLS, etc. Since here we have to do a server-to-server authentication from the Spring application, and both the Spring application and WSO2 Identity Server are within the secure network, it is preferable to use mutual TLS with self-signed certificates. Even though mutual TLS is the supported authentication mechanism in the Spring SACML SDK, it can be extended to support other authentication mechanisms as well. The main requirement to configure mutual TLS between the SDK and WSO2 IIS is to install public certificates of the servers in each other's trustos. Refer WSO2 docs to get more information on authenticating and authorizing REST APIs. Now let's look at the sequence diagram of the SACML authorization request response. First, Spring Security intercepts the incoming HTTP request and passes it on to the Attribute Evaluator component. Attribute Evaluator is the bridge between the SDK and Spring Security. Attribute Evaluator talks to SACML Auth Request Builder component and it will create the SACML request payload. Then the created request payload will be passed into the SACML Attribute Handler component. SACML Attribute Handler communicates with the PDP and returns the decision. In our case, PDP is WSO2 Identity Server. Then the result will be passed back to the Spring Security. In addition to the above mentioned components, SDK comes with the EH Cache Manager component. In this implementation, SACML Auth Request Builder and SACML Attribute Handler work with EH Cache Manager to minimize the latency. Now let's see the actual demonstration. Please note that I have already started my Spring Boot application, but you can start it by executing Spring Boot run command. If you stuck in any step, you can always refer the docs I have provided in the repository. Also, please note that you have to build the SDK before running the sample. First of all, go to localhost 8080. If everything is perfectly configured, you should be redirected to this login page. This UI is provided by WSO2 Identity Server. Now provide your username and password. The default one is admin. If everything is working, you should be redirected to this landing page. Now go to WSO2 Identity Server User Dashboard to verify whether SSO is working. You can see that I didn't have to log in here. That means SSO is working. Now go to this Hello page. This page is designed to add any number of headers to an outgoing request. In this demonstration, I am passing values via headers. So add action ID as read, then resource ID as this one. Then I'll submit the request. You can see that the request is successfully authorized. Now let's send the same request without adding any headers. You can see that I got an 403. Developers can use the SACML SDK in two ways. Use the pre-authorized annotation on the resource to use the SACML SDK, directly invoke the SDK from application code. Although in the demo I used headers in the HTTP request to extract attributes to pass in the SACML request, the SDK supports extracting attributes from query parameters, path parameters, body parameters and cookies. The SACML request is built using predefined templates. You can see the SACML request templates that I have configured in the SACML config.json configuration file. During the SACML authorization process, the placeholders in the configuration file will be replaced with the corresponding values in the incoming HTTP request. The mappings between the placeholders and attribute names are given as arguments to the pre-authorized annotation as shown in the example. There are a couple of more APIs that the SDK exposes, which can be directly invoked from the application code, which I will not discuss in this screencast. You will find more information on that in the documentation. Future improvements to consider for this implementation are embedding Balana SACML engine to Spring Security, administering multiple Spring Security PDPs from single PAP in WSO2 IS, improved caching implementations. Thank you.